Justin Bieber and Hailey Baldwin are engaged.
Selena Gomez reacts to Justin moving on.
And Cardi B gives birth to a baby girl.
All that and more on this week's DHR Recap.
Hey guys, welcome to the weekly recap of this week's biggest DHR stories. Kylie Jenner got slammed for a parenting decision she made.
Yeah, well, what else is new, right? Sure. But seriously, Justin Bieber and Hailey Baldwin getting engaged is still the most shocking news of not only the week, but maybe the entire year.
Yeah.
And I think you broke it down for us.
I did. So TMZ first reported the news that the Biebs had popped the question during a dinner date in the Bahamas on Sunday. The outlet reported that Justin proposed in front of everybody there, but not before his security asked everyone to put away their phones, obviously. Luckily for us, thanks to the public display of proposal, there were tons of witnesses to divulge all the romantic deets. A source told E! News, quote, "It happened Saturday in front of a crowd in Baker's Bay. Justin made arrangements for the ring when they were in New York City and knew that he wanted to propose to her. It was a sudden decision, but Justin always knew Hailey and him had a special bond that was incomparable." A source also told E! That when Justin popped the question, quote, "Her face was in shock, but you could tell they were both so in love." And really, everybody is feeling the love, because another source told E! Quote, "Justin is happier than ever and wants to be with Hailey. His family is very supportive and knows he has been at his best lately. Everyone is happy for him." So far, the fan reactions have been mixed, but like, are you surprised? Some people are so happy for them, while others are understandably heartbroken. One Twitter user tweeted, quote, "Justin Bieber is engaged to Hailey Baldwin, and I have never been so sad in my entire life. Did she know every word to every song? Did she go to his concert by herself? Did she buy all purple clothes because he said it was his favorite color? Did she even watch Never Say Never?" And while some fans were crying into their pillows, other fans feel heartbroken for Justin's ex, Selena. One fan tweeted, quote, "If Justin Bieber really is engaged to Hailey Baldwin, my heart breaks twice, once for myself and once for Selena."
So honestly, not lying, at first I did think that this was a totally fake rumor.
Me too. And like, after I heard it, I immediately thought, like, what is Selena Gomez going through?
I know.
Thankfully, we did get a reaction, and I think Nas brought us the story.
So when we heard the news of Hailey and Justin's engagement, our minds immediately went to Selena Gomez. What does Selena think? Does Selena even know? Is it possible Selena knew this was gonna happen? Whatever the case may be, it seems that Selena gives zero F's about this sudden engagement news, because Selena was all smiles while chilling on a yacht on Sunday with some pals. Check out these fan account videos that are making the rounds online. So it's safe to say this screenshot from the first clip is our favorite new unbothered meme. In addition to this cold hard evidence, though, that Selena is uninterested in the engagement, Us Weekly is reporting that Selgo doesn't care about Justin's new chapter. A source actually told the magazine, quote, "Selena doesn't care, she's over Justin, and the last time they broke up allowed her to get over him fully."
Real talk though, I am so happy that Selena is just out there living her best life.
Me too, but like, do you think Selena's over for real this time?
I think that, you know, him and Hailey getting married is pretty much a sign that Jaylee is the real deal.
But like, forever?
I think so. I'm really sorry. Hey, in other news, Jake Paul trashed a home. Like, how do you transition to Jake Paul, right? He trashed a home. He's in trouble again, you guys.
Jake Paul and the rest of Team 10 had a blast celebrating Jake's 21st birthday back in January, and the gang rented out a giant house in Aspen and got up to their usual shenanigans, which included riding various snow vehicles around, jumping off the side of the house, jumping onto a basketball hoop, and riding a bike straight into a tennis court net. Really safe fun.
Wow.
Well, turns out the owner of the house got word of the footage and she did not like what she saw. Her name is Isabel Friedheim, and she rented her house to Jake's manager, Krista Burnett, under the impression that Krista was using it for personal reasons. But instead, 18 people stayed in the home and allegedly trashed it. So the lawsuit claims that the Team 10 crew drove vehicles all over the lawn and the neighbors' lawns, pulled people on sleds throughout the neighborhood, blasted music at excessive levels, and even threw dishes at the windows and walls. And of course, much of this was caught on camera by the vloggers themselves. So Chris has already forked over $61,000 to cover cleaning fees and the security deposit, but the lawsuit also wants her to give up all her profits made from the videos Team 10 shot in Aspen, as well as pay additional damages and attorney fees. Since his manager is the only one involved in the lawsuit, Jake basically gets off scot-free.
Wow. Well, that's a shame. I wish I could say that I was even a little bit surprised.
I know, I read the headline, I'm like, meh. Sounds like Jake Paul.
All right, yeah.
But you guys, moving back on to Jaylee news, because we got a lot of it this week. Yeah. Justin confirmed the engagement in the cutest post ever, and NAS brought us the scoop.
Justin Bieber confirmed his engagement to Hailey Baldwin on Monday afternoon through an Instagram post. Justin wrote, quote, "Was gonna wait a while to say anything, but word travels fast. Listen, plain and simple, Hailey, I am so in love with everything about you, so committed to spending my life getting to know every single part of you, loving you patiently and kindly. My heart is completely and fully yours, and I will always put you first. You are the love of my life, Hailey Baldwin, and I wouldn't want to spend it with anybody else. You make me so much better, and we complement each other so well. Can't wait for the best season of life yet I die." And in more Justin and Hailey updates, we actually found out that Justin was actually pretty nervous to ask Hailes to marry him. Apparently, Justin sweated bullets before getting down on one knee to propose. An insider close to the Biebs opened up to People about everything that happened before the big moment. And they explained, quote, "Justin picked out the ring right before they flew to the Bahamas. He took Hailey on a special trip to propose. She didn't know." The same source also added that leading up to the proposal, Justin was, quote, "nervous but excited. He is super happy that she said yes."
Okay, honestly, that post made me believe in Jaylee just like a little bit.
Yeah, it actually was super cute. You were right. Also, other cute news, Cardi B and Offset, they had their baby, and Drew brought us that scoop.
There's no invasion of privacy when it comes to the birth of Cardi B and Offset's new bundle of joy. Cardi took to Instagram to let the world know that her baby has arrived. In the photo, she is surrounded by hundreds of beautiful flowers and simply captioned it with "Culture Kiari Cephas 71018" and tagged Offset. Cardi looks absolutely stunning in the photo. Culture with a K was born in Atlanta, and TMZ reports that Offset was by Cardi's side throughout. Offset's real name is Kiari Cephas, so we think it's really sweet that they incorporated that into their daughter's name. And we have to say that we are definitely happy that Cardi was the one to reveal the news. There were outlets reporting earlier this week that she was in labor, but she took to Twitter to shut that down. When a fan tweeted, "Why is people saying you in the hospital like it's mad annoying because they saying shit with no proof?" Cardi responded with the best response, saying, "I'm at home watching it."
I'm so happy for her and Offset.
I know, me too, honestly, I really, really am. But seriously though, what do you think of the name Culture? The internet had a lot to say about it.
I like the name Culture, but mainly because I think it's really funny that they used a K, considering all the Kardashians have their names that start with a K, and even when they're not spelled with a K, because Culture's spelled with a C. But you guys, smooth transition into a Kylie Jenner story. So Kylie Jenner found herself in some super hot water after she posted a video on Snapchat that revealed her daughter's ears are pierced, and naturally, the internet had some stuff to say about that.
Kylie Jenner is under fire yet again, and this time it's because of her latest parenting decision. Earlier this week, Kylie shared an adorable snap of herself giving Stormy some sweet, sweet lovin', and while Kylie's fans could not get enough of their cute interaction, others decided to fixate on what they thought was a more pressing matter, Stormy's pierced ears. One person tweeted, quote, "Stormy is less than 6 months old and Kylie's already got her ears pierced? Shouldn't be allowed at all." While another wrote, quote, "Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Who the hell pierces the ears of a baby? What comes next? Toddler tattoos?" Although it seems like a lot of people were upset by this move, quite a few actually came to Kylie's defense. One fan wrote, quote, "Why are people slating Kylie for having Stormy's ears pierced? I had my ears pierced before I turned one because when you're a baby, it's less painful and the child won't remember the pain. Like, sis, it's not that deep."
Oh my gosh, people need to give Kylie a break. I had my ears pierced when I was literally a few months old too.
I would have loved to have had my ears pierced when I was like one, because it hurts when you're older and you remember that pain.
Yeah.
Sitting in that chair at Claire's, you know? It's a memory I'll never forget.
Yeah, I will never forget that memory at like having to get my ears re-pierced. But I don't remember being one, I don't remember the pain. I am not emotionally and physically scarred for life from it, as I saw on the internet this week. It's actually, to me, so awful that she gets so much heat for doing things that I just like, I'm a mom, and also like I was a child. I was somebody's child once upon a time who had their ears pierced, a baby.
Sinead, you know who actually also has their ears pierced? Ariana Grande. And Ariana Grande just dropped her brand new single, For God Is a Woman.
Smooth.
And thank you so much. And it came with a music video. Ariana Grande has dropped the third single off of her upcoming album, Sweetener, a week early. God Is a Woman graced our favorite streaming sites just late last night, which sees Ariana play with her signature falsetto across different flows and entrancing beats. This song and its music video, which Ariana dropped today, are both on a whole new level. Song, Ariana is able to sing about what it's like to sleep with her without making any lyrics blatantly explicit. In the song, she suggests if you ever have the chance to meet her after midnight, you will believe that God is a woman. This, my friends, is what we call a sexual empowerment anthem, and we may have a new song of the summer on our hands. You believe God is a woman. Confirmed what the meaning of this track is, saying, quote, sexual female empowerment and how women are literally everything in the universe is inside us. We absolutely love that God Is a Woman is so different than any of her other Sweetener singles so far, and it seems like this song is actually one of Pete Davidson's favorites. During a Twitter Q&A sesh with her fans, a fan asked Ari to tell the world which song off of her new album is Pete's favorite, and here's what she and Pete had to say. Quote, passing the phone, God Is a Woman is my favorite. It makes me cry every time I hear it. You guys are gonna the whole album is fire. And obviously I love the song called Pete. You guys are gonna freak out.
I like the video. I'm a little bit confused. The song's really cool. It's very sexy. I need to watch this video a lot more times than just once. It's still fresh. It's still very fresh.
There's like a lot going on in the video. I love the song. I like the video, but I'm definitely gonna have to watch it at least.
What was your favorite part again?
What?
When the like moles or chipmunks.
Oh my gosh, what is with the groundhogs coming up and screaming?
Yeah.
I had to show Sinead and Emil in our office. I'm like, I don't know what's happening.
We actually laughed really hard because we were, I thought it was an ad. I thought it was a YouTube ad starting. I really didn't know it was still part of the music video.
It probably has some deep meaning and we're just dumb.
Yeah.
We don't realize it, but yeah. You guys, you may think we don't read your comments, but we do, and this is our favorite part of the show.
Yay.
We go through and see all your thoughts on all of our stories throughout the week, and you guys had a lot to say about Jaylee, Angelina, everyone. So my favorite comment came from Olivia Summer, who said, in quotations, we're better as friends, which is what Haley was saying in an interview like 2 weeks before Justin and Haley got
true.
Back together.
It's true.
And then she said 2 seconds later, never mind, we're getting married. Olivia, I had the same thought process. I was telling everyone in the office, I'm like, Haley literally just said that they're better platonically, so why are they getting married now?
This is probably why I thought it was like a fake rumor at first, because I was like, dude, she just said they're just friends. They're like really working on their friendship. And then they were engaged. But you know what? People were also like really, really heartbroken over the Jaylee news, especially Selena fans and Jolina fans, because I know we have some in the office too, and we are two of them, that truly loved Jolina. So this one comes from, I'ma keep it real, and they did. They said, as soon as Selena finds another, Justin will lose all control and try to win her back. Look how many likes that comment has. A lot of people, no dislikes either, by the way. A lot of people seem to really be questioning Jaylee's relationship, and it's just so interesting because we really have, as a fandom, become so invested in what is going on with Selena Gomez and Justin Bieber.
We'll never let it die. I mean, honestly, like, Haley and Justin will be celebrating their 40th wedding anniversary, and we'll be like, well, what about Selena? What's Selena doing?
Yeah, total, like 100%.
Yeah. All right, guys, that wraps up this week's weekly recap of the biggest DHR stories of the week. But we want to hear from you guys. Which was your favorite? Which was the most shocking? Let us know right down in the comments below.
Honestly, what a great week of stories. All right, we'll be back next week. Until then, make sure you guys are subscribed to Clever so you can hang out with us every day because we're here doing this.
All the time.
Every day.
Mm-hmm. All right, guys, then click right over here because if you need even more Jaylee news, we got all the deets on Hailey Baldwin's engagement ring.
Spoiler alert, it's amazing.
It's so pretty.
Also, you guys, hit that subscribe button so you can hang out with us every day.
Every day.
Every
we'll
day.
We'll be here. Don't you want to? Click it. Click it.